Where is your gun now?
Don't be cornering me. Hold up. Time. You gotta help me with that corner shit.
What's up, kidfolk? It's RJ Young. I am not on a step mill. Consider hitting the like and subscribe button because I upload a video every single day. It's always college football related, sports related. We have a good time. Today, we gotta talk about LSU going D-O-W-N to Mississippi State. Welcome to air raid hell. But before we get to that, I gotta ask y'all, like, where's your man's at? Where's your DBU man's at? Where's Ryan Clark? Honey Badger? Pat Peterson? Where's your man's at? Where's all the folks that was telling me that the LSU is going to be great this year? The LSU is not going to catch five losses. Caught one today. Look, where's all the folks that was telling me that your man's Miles Brennan was the truth, right? Joe Burrow part two. Where's all them folks? Like, I thought that y'all told me that Miles Brennan was just going to be out here torching people. That Terrace Marshall and Eric Gilbert was all y'all needed. That Chris Curry and Ty Davis Prowse was going to hold y'all down. But that ain't what I've been seeing over here, man. What I've been seeing over here, man, is trash. Like, you put up 34 points on a Mississippi State team with a first-year head coach that ain't really had no time to run much of anything. And then Miles Brennan gonna get sacked 7 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times. My man goes 27-44 for 344 and looks so bad doing it, right? Like, Terrace Marshall was Terrace Marshall, 8 for 122. That's a positive. That's a real positive. Can't run the ball, though. Like, 9 for 47 for Chris Curry. 11 for 44 for Ty Davis Price. What are we doing? 7 for 27 for John Emery. Meanwhile, KJ Costello, 36 of 60 for 623 yards. 600 from Mississippi State over the number 6, LSU, over the defending national champion, LSU, joining OU as two of the top 6 teams to catch L's. Yeah, I'm right here down with you, baby. You can't dodge me. We in this together. Now, as I am recording this upload, Texas has to go into overtime against Texas Tech, 56 up, in a game where Texas was favored by 17 points to beat Texas Tech on the road. But I just want to stick with LSU over here because it was a dream in Arkansas, right? I'm pulling for Arkansas because they are managing to somehow win this rock fight against Georgia early on. Like, the score was like 7-5 at one point and 7-2. And then, of all things, Dwan Mathis looks absolutely awful. So bad that I'm going, if JT Daniels was cleared to play football, they would have him out there playing football. And I'm so sure that because Stetson Bennett came out the bullpen in the second quarter with 10 minutes left to play in the second quarter because he could simply run the offense, right? Not because Dwan Mathis is not an athlete, but because Stetson Bennett could run the offense. This is a guy that gone to Georgia, wasn't going to play, went JUCO, and then came back to Georgia. He's the dude I'm making fun of for getting to wear a Georgia jersey. Meanwhile, Colin Hill and KJ Costello just pull off a 44-34 W against your Bayou Bengals, the 2019 defending national champion Bayou Bengals. I told y'all you can't lose what you lost and expect to be good. 5 losses. Been saying it for months. I get LSU fans coming in this comments of this channel trying to talk mad trash to me about what I know about college football, talking about I be losing credibility. Y'all caught an L too, dog. Like, I'm not on here telling you about Oklahoma and how many wins and losses they were going to have. You notice that? Ain't nobody ever point that out, though. I never did a win totals for the Big 12. And yet, you look at Oklahoma and you're going, young, 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 young. Just like LSU. Hello, first-year starters at quarterback, right? You really got to trust some of these skill players. Your coach is trying to navigate a COVID situation ain't nobody had to navigate before. And you lost more than Oklahoma lost offensively and defensively with a new defense coordinator. I don't care what you think you know about Bo Pelini. He just gave up 623 yards passing. Like, what are we doing? We didn't have Derek Stingley. Yeah, that's probably worth what? 3 points? I'll give you a touchdown. You're not supposed to lose by 10 to Mississippi State. You damn sure not supposed to get 600 yards put up on you. That's why I'm looking for the DBs. Like, somebody's like, call out Mark Spears. Nah. His time will come. I'm looking for the DBs. I'm looking for the folks to talk about DBU, right? The folks be like, RJ, why you keep talking about Ohio State like it's DBU? Because it is. Y'all proving that right now. You don't reload. That's not who y'all are. You are not Alabama. You're not Ohio State. You're not Clemson. You're LSU, which is good. That's great. That's fine. Nobody's saying don't be LSU. It's when y'all get too big for your britches that I have to come and sun you. Humility. That's all we looking for. Saying you're going to catch 5 losses? That's what it was going to be. J. just not going to be your year. Talking about I can see two, I can see three. Yeah, dog. One of those was not Mississippi State. Okay? One of them was not Mississippi State. You still got Auburn to play, LSU to play. Ampersand U is better than you. Right? You got Florida to play. There's the four. Right there. You trying to tell me? Y'all been trying to tell me that y'all somehow feel like y'all can do this. Like, my God. Osiris Mitchell eating today. My man has 7 catches for 183 yards. Kylin Hill had 8 catches for 158 yards. My God. Javonte Payton had 6 catches for 122 yards. Meanwhile, Mike Leach didn't even pretend like he was trying to run a football. They had 15 rushes for like nothing. And I'm counting the rushes of being like with KJ Costello, who wasn't really rushing. You don't count him. It's 10 rushes total for 49 yards. They knock off the number 6 team in the country in his first game of his first year, his first time at SEC West, his first time bringing air raid hell to the rest of y'all. Y'all making fun of the Big 12, talking about they don't play no defense in the Big 12. Nah, dog, we just really good at playing offense, and now you understand that as Mike Leach showed up and showed you what's really good in Tiger Stadium, in Baton Rouge. You got this put on you in Baton Rouge with Corey Foreman and them on site. Y'all got pulled up in your grandmama front yard and got clap, clap, took you out. Holy smokes. Who are you? Who are you? You're over. Like, you're worse than Oklahoma because Oklahoma got to win. Y'all went conference only. Talk about, see, we not trying to play no Missouri States. We not trying to get beat by no Sunbelts. We going to play each other. It's hard enough in the SEC. Uh-huh. Yeah, it's hard enough in the SEC. That's why you 0 for 1. That's why you are winless. Winless. Through the... Going in October, you are winless, LSU. That's you, homie. You a loser. Talking to you. Stay out the comments over here. Unless you want to commiserate. You want to cry together, we can cry together. You want to come humbly, we can do it humbly. We can go to church. We can go to church. You know what I mean? We can hold hands. We can talk noise about Bama. We can talk noise about Georgia. We can talk noise about Texas. You know? But it ain't been a fun experience with y'all the last 4 months. It ain't been fun. All y'all been doing is talking mad trash. And then when stuff like this happens, I got to pull your card. I got to let you know where you are, which is in the dumpster with the rest of us. Yeah. And we a little bit higher on that rung because we got a W in the win column. Give a damn, we had to pay $600,000 for the night. We got the win, do you? Huh? No. You had your greasy game scheduled with your FCS opponent kicking off the schedule. Yeah. Dodging Texas. Dodging Oklahoma, for that matter. You replaced the game with Oklahoma with Texas. Get out of here, man. Look, as much as I would really like to continue to talk about how bad y'all are, I got to go check on Texas. Because, my God, if Texas loses this game, I mean, dissolve the Big 12 anyway. But this has already been a banner day for Blood Week. Copyright shutdown forecast. Deuces.